Welcome to my class, student. It's class 8, English Lit. It so happened, this is chapter 2, Children at Work. This is session 1. In this session, we are going to read the text. In this story, as the title suggests, we are seeing children who are at work. So, what type of children are these? Let's see in the story. Velu. An 11 years old boy runs away from home. Who are the children who are at work? Run away from home. And this is a story of a 11 years old boy, Velu. He wanders around for hours before getting on a train to Chennai without a ticket. As he has left his home, so he doesn't have money, so without ticket, he wants to board on a train and he wants to go to Chennai. Tired and hungry, he doesn't know where to go when a stranger at the station shouts the word of welcome. So he was waiting for a train. So then he comes to know about a girl who is a stranger and she just acknowledges him and says him hello. Right? So in this way, you are saying the story will start in this first part of the story. When the Kanyakumari Express pulled in at Chennai Central, it took Velu some time to get off. Right? So he was 11 years old, and when the Kanyakumari Express, that is the name of the train, pulled it in the Chennai Central, that is the name of the station, the Velu took some time to get up. When he finally stood on the platform, his legs felt wobbly. Wobbly means still he is feeling is in the train, as if he was still on a moving train. It happens with all of us. Oi, out of the way. A porter went by with a loaded trolley. Velu jumped aside. As he was standing there, suddenly he heard a noise, or he heard a sentence, oi, out of the way. He just looked behind and he found a porter who was with a loaded trolley, and he wanted the boy to go little bit sideways so that he could make his way. Now pulled in means arrived, and ubli means unsteady. He sat on a bench on the platform. Who sat on the bench? Velu sat on the bench on the platform, putting his small bundle down. Small bundle, as he has left his home, he has run away from his home. So whatever his necessary articles are, he has put it in a piece of cloth and just tied as a bundle. And so that small bundle he has put down, and he is there sitting on the bench of the platform. In all his 11 years, he had never seen so many people. Where is he? He is in the station. And so many people he had never seen because he was a village boy. Except once a year at the fair in his village. In the village, once he went to the fair, and there he saw so many people. And the same number of people he is seeing in the railway station. People walked by bumping into him with their suitcases. As this is a railway station, people have their luggage, their bag and baggages, and they are just bumping into him with their luggage. A voice announced something on a loudspeaker. This is just a scene of a station. So Velu sat on a bench on the platform, putting his small bundle down. As you know, he has a bundle. He has his necessary articles that he has brought from his home. And it is in a piece of cloth, that is in a form of bundle he has with him. And he has put that bundle down. In all his 11 years, he had never seen so many people. He has seen this number of people only once he visited to a fair in his village. So he is finding similarity between a fair and a station because the number of people are the same there. Now, People walked by bumping into him with their suitcases. As you know, they are all travelers, they have their luggage. So what happened? They are all bumping into him with their suitcases. Because he is there idly, he is waiting there, he is on the bench and someone is going in hurry, you know, everyone is in hurry there. So they are bumping into him with their suitcases. A voice announced something on a loudspeaker. As you know, this is a picture of a station. He is at station. So every time you find announcement, some train is coming, some train is going, and passengers, they address the passengers also. So all these things are announced sometime in the something on a loudspeaker. Near him, a group of people sat on their luggage. See, this is a complete picture of a station. When you go to a station, you find there are people who are sitting on their luggage, looking at a TV hanging from the roof. What is displaying on the TV? They display the timing of the train's arrival and the departure. So someone is, many people are sitting on their luggage and looking at the TV that is showing the arrival time and the departure time of trains. The noise was terrible. Now in the station, as it is filled with so many people, announcement is going on. So the noise was terrible. It was hard to bear. Velu put his head down on his knees. So he was very tired. He came by train. Then he is seeing at a strange place. He is seeing so many people. So what he had done, he has put his head down on his knees, feeling miserable and exhausted. Why feeling miserable? He is feeling very bad and very sad and very helpless, miserable and very exhausted. He is very tired. He had run away from his village 2 days ago. That means 2 days ago he has run away from his village and he has reached at the Chennai Central. Here, this is understood that he is without food now. For 2 days he had eaten nothing but some peanuts and a piece of jaggery. He has eaten nothing, some peanuts and jaggery. In his bundle he carried a shirt, a towel and a comb. The only article that he has with him is shirt, towel and a comb. And he was feeling very hungry. He was very tired. He was finding himself very helpless. He had walked for most of the first day to Kannur and then got on the train to Chennai. So he walked down for most of the day to Kannur. Kannur is a place. From there he got the train to Chennai. Well, you had no money for a ticket, but luckily the ticket collector did not come to the unreserved compartment. As this was the unreserved compartment, everyone was allowed to sit there, but without ticket, not surely. But as the ticket checker didn't come there, nobody caught Velu without ticket. He had tried to sleep on the floor near the door. That's in the train, he tried to sleep on the floor, but there he found a group of men next to him had played cards and shouted all night. That's why he is very exhausted. He didn't have his sleep also. Hey, what? New to town? Yeah, called out a rough voice. When he was sitting there with his head down on his knees, what voice did he hear? Hey, what? New to town? Yeah, called out a rough voice. When he opened his eyes, there were a lot of people standing around, but nobody was looking at him. So who is calling? Who is trying to talk to him? Here, yeah, he turned around. Then again he heard the same sound. Here, yeah. Then when he turned around, behind him was a girl around his own age. What is the age of value? 11 years. So the girl's age was the same. Wearing a long banyan that came down to her knees. So girl didn't have a proper dress. She was wearing a long banyan. Her hair was stiff and brownish and she had a huge sack on one shoulder. So what picture, what idea we are getting of the girl? She was very poor. Her hair was very stiff and brownish, and she had a huge sack at one of her shoulder. She was picking up dirty plastic cups from the floor. So, who is that girl? She is a rag picker and stuffing them into her sack. Why is she calling me? Thought Velu. And why is a girl wearing a banyan? Now, this is the first thing. There are so many things that amazed Velu. First, many people are there, loudspeaker. And now, she has seen a girl wearing a banyan. Banyan is meant for the boy. And here the girl has worn it. So, he is asking to himself, why the girl is in banyan? See, the girl, here is a Velu, 11 years old boy. This is his bundle. This is a girl. And see the station. Train is here. People are going here and there. And the girl is in banyan. She has a sack on her shoulder. And see her hair. These are very untidy, stiff. And there is a plastic cups. And her work is to pick it up. See, there is a plastic cup in her hand. Very good illustration, and we are getting an idea of the characters. No need to stare stupidly. What's your name? So, Velu was just looking at her, a girl in banyan. So, what the girl said? No need to stare stupidly. What's your name? Velu, muttered Velu, looking away. So, Mr. Velu, said the girl, looking at his bundle. Run away from whom? That means it was understood. Everybody could understand that he has run away from whom. Velu didn't answer. He didn't want to tell some strange girl what he had done. Obviously, why will he say his secrets? Why will he talk to a stranger? So, he didn't say anything. He had run away because he couldn't stand his father beating him for one more day. His father was very aggressive. He used to beat him every day. His father would snatch away all the money Velu and his sisters earned and spend it on drink. So his father was a drunkard. He used to spend all the money that the children earned after hard work, and he used to spend it on drink. Don't think I don't know. This place is full of children like you. The girl is saying, you think I don't know? If you look around, you will find so many children like you. So, what are you going to do here? Become rich? Now, what is the general idea that we have? If someone is running away from village to city, that means he or she wants to become rich. Is this the way? Is this truth? No, this is not a truth. So many difficulties they face in city. But so the girl is also saying, the girl also has the same thinking, and she is saying, you have come from your village because you want to become rich here in the city. She sat down next to him. Velu sifted away slightly. If some girl sits near a boy, and if a boy sits near a girl, so it happens. Now, they sifted away slightly because he was not her friend. So, this happened. He felt hunger pinching him and pressed his stomach with a grimace. Now, 2 days ago, he left his home 2 days ago. He didn't have anything except that peanut and jaggery. Now he was feeling very hungry, and it is felt by not by him only, but by the girl also. Hungry? Asked the girl. Now his facial expression was explaining his condition. You won't get food by sitting here gloomily, making faces. I can find some if you want. If you keep on sitting here and you will make faces like this, nobody will give you anything to eat. Let's go with me and I have something to give you. I can find something if you want. That means a rag picker is saying, offering her help just to Velu to find some food articles for the boy. She picked up her sack and started to walk away. Velu stayed on the bench. What should he do? Should he follow this girl? Where was he going to take him? She was disappearing into the crowd. So he had to make up his mind quickly. Now, see, he is in a station. Everyone is stranger there. And one girl, she wants to offer him some food if she find. So he doesn't want her to lose. He wants her to be his companion so that he can get adjusted in the city life. So what happened? He was just thinking, should he follow this girl? But the girl has started walking. So she might disappear in the crowd. So what he said, he thought, yeah, he should follow the girl. All right, he decided. Anyway, I have no idea where to go. He jumped up and ran after her. Okay, as I don't have any idea where to go, I am new to the city, so it's okay to follow the girl. She wasn't even looking back to see where he was. But the girl is very practical and she didn't look back to see where he was. She just left the place and walked away. So, what have we learned today? We have learned in the first part of the chapter, there are two characters. One is Velu, 11 years old boy who has run away from his house because his father used to beat him. And there is a girl who is a rag picker, and she understood that Velu has left home and he is a stranger in the city, in the central, in Chennai central. So she wanted to offer him some food articles as she understood that Velu was very hungry. So what happened next? In the next session, in the next class, I will say you, we will read the next part of the story. Till then, have a good revision of this. Read the words, understand the story, see the illustration, and we will meet again in the next class. Thank you.